service. So I'll touch around you this flight with the card only on one day except the Visa, MasterCard and
Assalamu Alaikum and welcome back to my channel. I hope yous are all doing well inshallah. Today we are in Sofia in Bulgaria. We're here for the next 3 days. I've got a list of 7 things that we want to do and one of them is the only mosque here in Sofia. So inshallah I'm planning to take my mum inside. It's open to visitors and I think they give you an abaya at the door, so look out for that. We're going to hopefully do that in the afternoon. The first stop is the National Palace of Culture. It's about a 20 minute walk from our hotel. It looks absolutely stunning with nice fountains and everything outside. So let's head there and see what it's like. So this is it here, the National Palace of Culture. I think down here is where there's normally like the water fountain, but they're not on just now. There is a Christmas market there. Maybe that's why they're switched off, or maybe they come on later on in the day. I'm not too sure. But that is our first stop of Sofia. That's the building just there. And Mum noticed if you look down here, there's this really cool design. It looks so nice. It's just a bit of a shame because there is graffiti all over, like you can see it all over the walls there. That does let the place down a little bit, but it is very, very nice here. This is the Vitosha Boulevard. This is also a recommended place while you're here in Sofia, and this is what it looks like. Just a lot of different shops on the side, a lot of restaurants and clothes shops. We are looking for a magnet shop, of course. So this was all discovered from when they started digging up the ground to create the subway. This is us now at the next stop. This is called the Largo and it is 3 buildings. My mum's going to explain to you because I don't fully understand.
Apparently the different socialist buildings. So this, oh, I can't do it. I'm not a historian.
So here's 1 building, 2 and 3. I think it's to do with politics, isn't it? Okay, so what it says on Wikipedia is the Largo is an architectural assemble of 3 socialist classisms in central Sofia. So there you go. That's what Wikipedia is saying, so that's what we're going with. But it is very lovely. And that statue of that lady is right over there behind. Let's take a little walk down here and see what's going on. I'm seeing quite a few vloggers or people with selfie sticks anyway. Love to see it. I'm not the only one. This here is the central mineral bath. And in Bulgaria, I think there are 49 hot springs. And we just seen one just over here. As you walk up, you can see the steam coming off. It's really hot. There is a sign here saying no bathing, washing and washing up, but I think people come along here with their water bottles and fill up. We just seen a lady do it just now. The view of this building is absolutely gorgeous. Really, really lovely. I love the architecture here in this country. Our next stop was supposed to be the central market hall, which is there, but we've walked around the entire building. It's shut for reconstruction, so that's a shame because it did look like you could get some nice different food places in there and little shops and things, but never mind. Now we're gonna go and try some traditional Bulgarian food. It is called banitsa, I think. Banitsa, and it's a pastry that's got cheese in the middle of it. So I've put in a restaurant or a little cafe and that's where we're heading just now. This is a little cafe here that it came up with. So this is the traditional pastry here with the cheese inside. This is a small one, the large must be massive. And this is a traditional drink.
I don't know what it is, but I'm gonna try it anyway. It's so best for me work.
It's so warm, and you would expect it to be like cheese really, really strong, but it's not. It's actually really, really good.
It's nice.
What do you think?
It's lovely, really nice.
That was very, very good.
I have to try the juice. I can't open it.
What does it smell? Oh, it smells like beef or something.
I think it smells like Marmite.
Oh, it's hot.
No.
Is it not like really. Beef or something? No, thank you.
I can't.
I can't drink it. Smells vile.
I wouldn't really recommend getting the drink. The pastry's lovely, but the drink isn't my thing. I think it's like a Bovril, isn't it? Mm. That's what it's like, a Bovril.
Or Oxo or something.
Yeah.
That pastry was just so, so good, and it's really nice to try something that's traditional to the country that you're in. So next stop is the largest cathedral here in Bulgaria. This came up at the top rated place to go and see, and it is called St. Alexander Nevsky Cathedral. So it's about a 12 minute walk from the pastry shop, and that's where we're headed just now. Them pastries that we had were 7 Bulgarian LEV equals, I think that's the currency, which works out at £3.11, which is so good because also had the drink included. If that was in the UK, the drink alone would be about £5 or £6. So that's us here now. That is the cathedral. There's quite a lot of works going on outside, so I'm not sure if you can hear me too well. But my mum would quite like to go inside, so we're gonna see if we're allowed to go in and visit. I came out of there quite quickly because I felt like I was getting some awkward looks and I didn't like it. Even the priest kind of looked at me like I had two heads or something. So anyhow, we have finished everything on our list, but we've left the best till last. We are now heading to the mosque. I honestly don't know how to say it. Bani Bashi Mosque, I think. I have no idea. That's where we're headed just now. I really hope that it's still open for visitors, and I hope that I can take my mum in. And I really hope that my mum won't get a reception like I just did in the cathedral. So looking forward to it, inshallah. This is us at the Largo again, but this is us underneath. So you can see again, there's the 3 buildings. And then this is us actually underneath. And there's loads of ruins down here as well. What did you think about your experience?
It was really lovely, really peaceful. It was nice, yes, I enjoyed it.
Yeah, so nice in there.
Uh-huh.
They had hijabs at the front for you to wear, so visitors were all welcome. And I wasn't sure, but there was actually a bias as soon as we went into the corner. So I managed to pick one up and I could pray after while we were there. The design and everything inside, really beautiful.
Yeah, it was lovely, really nice.
Really nice. Yeah.
I enjoyed it.
Yeah, I always like the feeling inside a mosque. It just feels just calm, I
peaceful,
think.
Peaceful, and it's like you leave your worries behind. It's just a safe place, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's always so beautiful to go inside. Mm-hmm. Yeah, really nice. Glad that we went, and even if you're non-Muslim, I'd highly recommend going. Would you?
Yeah, definitely.
This was actually in the top 10 things to do here in Sofia, so even if you're non-Muslim, definitely check it out. Really, really nice there, and yeah, welcoming to non-Muslims as well. They have the abayas and the hijabs at the door for you, so yeah, definitely recommend. That is everything on our list finished now. I think we'll probably find somewhere to have dinner, maybe, do you think?
Yeah, or a cake or something.
Okay. Oh, fridge magnet.
We can't forget the fridge magnet.
I think that'll be the next stop, fridge magnet, inshallah. Let's go. Mum's just got some questions about the mosque. I thought it'd be quite nice just to put the camera on and then I can try my best to answer them. So you asked, first of all, is women allowed to go to the prayer on a Friday?
Yes.
Yeah, so women are welcome. I think women get more of a reward if they do pray at home, but yeah, of course they're more than welcome to go, and it's compulsory for males to go on the Friday, and it's normally about lunchtime.
Is it?
Yeah, the prayer.
What was the name of the
you said
that
yeah
led the meeting of?
Yeah, so they'd be called an imam.
Imam.
Yeah,
and do you
they
ever
lead the
have
prayer.
Female?
No, never female, it's always male. Mm-hmm. And do you have any questions about maybe why women have to be in a separate part?
Yeah, I was thinking about that as well, yeah.
So it's because the prayer is very physical. You're going down to the ground and you don't want a man behind you that could be staring at your bum. So that's why the women are always behind, and more than likely we're always upstairs. I've been to some mosques where we're on the side of them, but you're never directly in front of them.
So that makes sense.
Yeah, because you're bending down so that they could lose concentration.
I think a lot of people don't realise that.
Yeah, a lot of people
don't.
And
I think they think that they're just put up there as second class.
I was one of them. I used to think, oh, women aren't treated well, and why are they always, like, they have like a separate entrance and stuff like that, but it's all to protect the women.
Yeah.
It's not, nothing. The women in Islam are so, so protected. Say if I'm to pray with Hamza, so Hamza will always be slightly in front of me to the side.
Yeah.
I still wouldn't be in front of Hamza, even though he's my husband, I still wouldn't be in front of him because he could get distracted, and it's that's just the way that it is. I'm to go behind, and always it would be him leading it as well. I would never be the one leading it because he's the man.
Yeah.
So if me and him were to pray together, he would be the one leading it.
But that makes sense.
Yeah.
It makes
you feel protected as well, because you know we're up the stairs there praying. We're not at the bottom with the men at the top staring at us. So it's all to benefit the women, really. Uh-huh. Do you have any other questions?
No, it was nice when I came out as well. There was a few men putting the shoes back on, and they moved aside for me.
Yeah.
I mean, I thought that was so nice because they didn't have to.
Yeah.
Very good. I enjoyed that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
No, it was
a
good.
Nice finish to all the things
to a busy
you
day.
Do,
yeah.
Honestly,
yeah. Really,
really
nice. And I'm glad that you came out in as well.
It was restful too.
Yeah.
I'm not sure though, because I like all of them. Again.
So Mum's happy, she finally got something sweet to eat. She went for the biscoff. The biscoff, what is that, a waffle? And I went for a bubble tea. Alright, let me try yours, bismillah.
That nice? Oh, do you want some more?
No, it's okay. It's thick cream.
Oh, that's me.
Bismillah. That's really good as well. That's really good. Come on, try. It's now a few hours later. We went back to the hotel and relaxed for a little bit. I don't know if you can actually see me, it's so dark. We've come back to our first stop here, the Museum of Culture, because we were hoping to see all the lights down the middle, but there's still none. So I did look at it online. I think it's only certain events that they put all the lights on. I think they said they did it 3 days ago to support UNICEF, and they lit everything up blue. Shame that we're not seeing lit up, but never mind. This is actually our third time back here today hoping to see the lights, but never mind. We're feeling quite hungry now though. We're going to go and find a restaurant and get something to eat. So we've just come into a traditional Bulgarian restaurant. It looks so nice in here.
We've just ordered. I went for a vegetarian dish, Mum went for lamb, and we got a couple of fruit juices, some fresh bread, and then some potatoes with cheese. So looking forward to trying it. It's really, really nice in here. It's really authentic, isn't it? Really nice.
Look at all the seats. Really, really nice in here.
So the first couple of dishes have arrived. This is potatoes with cheese, and then this is a traditional bread. That is actually so good. The bread's so thin. I was expecting the bread to be so much thicker. I'm not really a fan of the bread. It's like charcoal. Is it good?
Mains have arrived. This is a one pot dish. It's a vegetarian with like tomatoes and cheese. Oh, and there's a little date. That's nice. And then there's Mum's, the lamb. What is that again?
Yogurt.
Yeah, and yogurt. Salad. Salad, lamb. And that looks like rice, I think. That is so good. I'm actually such an idiot. I said that was a date. It's actually a chili. The restaurant there, if you're ever in Sofia. Honestly, was not expecting that at all. At all. As soon as we went in, it was quite quiet, and we just thought it'd be quite nice to try their own traditional food. Then they just came out and they started dancing, they were wearing the traditional clothes, they dressed up as a horse at one point. It was just so, so crazy. Each time they came out, I was more and more shocked. But it was really, really nice to go there, and I would definitely recommend going. So that's us now heading back to the hotel. Tomorrow, inshallah, we're getting picked up by a bus at 8 in the morning, and we're heading to North Macedonia for the day. And then we will be leaving at 2 in the morning the next day. So this is our last day here in Bulgaria. Our one and only day really, but we did absolutely everything that we planned to do. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, give it a like, give me a comment, let me know what you think. And I'll see you in the next vlog, inshallah.
Bye. Bye.